Hello children, welcome back to your SST class. Today we will proceed with the concluding part of the chapter, the first cities. In the previous video, you studied about the main civilizations in the ancient times. Also studied that the earliest civilization flourished around the river banks. Now we will continue with the Indus Valley civilizations. We will study the town planning, drainage system, farming, trade, commerce, etc. about the Indus Valley civilizations. Town planning. The houses were built with burnt bricks and were constructed along the both sides of the roads. The houses were of different living quarters for the rich and the poor. They even had bathrooms. Many cities were divided into two main groups. The western part of the city was raised to about 30 to 50 feet above the ground and was known as citadel. All public buildings such as granaries have been found in the citadel. A town hall is also found in Mohenjo-daro, which was probably used as an auditorium or a prayer hall. The drainage system in the Harappan cities had a well-developed sewage system. The streets had drains covered with large slabs. Since they were covered, there were holes at regular intervals for cleaning. Large oblong structure has been unearthed in the citadel in Mohenjo-daro. Archaeologists call it the Great Bath. Steps from two sides led down to the structure. There were even changing rooms around the bath. Granaries are also found in Harappa. Granaries show that people grew wheat and barley. There is no substantial information about the political and social life of the people. The figure of a bearded man has been found, who might have been a political or a religious head. The Harappan cities were flooded regularly by the Indus and its tributaries, which deposited silt in the surrounding areas. The land was very fertile. The chief occupation of the Indus Valley people was agriculture and the domestication of animals. Archaeologists also recovered several types of toys and pottery, which were used for storing the granaries. They are designed in different ways. Seals of different sizes with a variety of designs have been found at many Harappan sites. It is possible that seals were used by merchants as a form of identification. Some seals were used as amulets. The fact that seals have been found in Mesopotamia indicates that products from Indus Valley reached there. Bronze figures, seals, and pottery provide clues about the religious beliefs of the Indus Valley people. A humped bull, elephant, and rhinoceros engraved on seals indicate that these animals may have been considered sacred. In Harappa, the most striking deity is a horned god. Some scholars identify him with the Hindu god Shiva, who is also known as Pashupati. Terracotta images of mother goddess have also been found in the excavations. The peepal tree and the serpents were also worshipped. The script used by the Indus Valley people is one of the earliest known script. It was a picture-based script with each picture or symbol representing a word or sound. These writings are mostly found on seals. Historians have not been able to decipher the script, so the information they contain is still hidden from us. Now, the decline. The Indus Valley civilization lasted for about 1.5 millennia. Archaeologists believe that its decline began by 1500 BCE. Consider several possibilities for the decline of the Indus Valley civilization. At some Indus Valley sites, a layer of ash has been found. Some historians believe this could have been because of a large-scale burning down the settlements. Another cause can be natural calamities such as flood or earthquake. The changes in the course of River Indus left the cities without a source of water. This forced people to move. Another reason is environmental caused by deforestation. Okay, students, now study the chapter thoroughly, and if you have any problem, you can ask me. Bye-bye.